Welcome to the second edition of our UpLoad video magazine for 2025. Today, we come direct from Bauma in Munich with a few new products to show you. We showcase another Licon 3 crane, the LTM 1150-5.4 with the new Licon 3 control generation and, as an electric version, the LTM 1150-5.4E. The LTM 1150-5.4 has a whole range of new features, Julia. What makes this new crane so interesting for customers?
Sure, Martin. With its new Licon 3 control system, the LTM 1150-5.4 boasts features that improve not just operation, but also overall safety. We have taken the feedback from customers that we got last year and integrated it into the new crane control system, making the crane even more user-friendly.
Safety is certainly the word, because the new crane is also bristling with driver assistance systems.
Absolutely. This crane has a blind spot information system, a moving off information system, and a reversing information system. All of these systems support and warn the driver about other road users, pedestrians and cyclists.
So how does it work in practice?
Our 5-axle model is a really cost-effective crane. It can be driven on roads with a total weight of 60 tons, featuring 9 tons of ballast, making it a true taxi crane. In other words, the crane operator saves on having to transport any ballast at all. The new driver's cab also features a completely revamped climate control system, new consoles, and a multifunction steering wheel.
And alongside these innovations, the LTM 1150-5.4 is now also available as an electric model.
That's right. The drive concept for the LTM 1150-5.4E builds on the proven technology of our LTC 1050-3.1E. The unique thing about it, however, is that we've given the crane an upgrade. It now has a battery pack. With this battery pack, it can work 24/7 when plugged in, and even autonomously for up to 4 hours.
It's brilliant, efficient, and sustainable. Julian, thanks for these insights.
My pleasure.
So far, there have been different approaches to maintenance for our cranes. The one thing in common, however, is that every service carried out is documented or noted with pen on paper. In future, this is going to be done for mobile cranes like our LTM 1650-8.1 with the Digital Service Booklet. We're going to take a look in our Digital Products and Services sector now to see how exactly it works. Stefan Stöckler-Thuren is our product owner and is able to tell us what lies behind the concept of the new Digital Service Booklet. Hi, Stefan.
Hi, Martin. The Digital Service Booklet is a brand new tool intended to make servicing and maintaining our customers' machinery significantly simpler. It offers a user-friendly user interface that maps all of the information relating to servicing. And the great thing about it is that it can be used not just by our customers, but also by our own service engineers.
Great. Could we maybe run through a sample service using the LTM 1650-8.1?
Yes, of course. So on the left here, you can see the general information about the machine we're talking about. Below this, you'll see the information about the last completed service, and on the right, for example, you can document a service call. That's what I'm doing right now. And then I've got the option of entering vehicle-specific and service-related data. Here, you've got the opportunity to complete this machine-specific checklist, as I mentioned earlier, find information about the activities that need to be carried out, and also leave notes.
And what's the specific advantage here?
There are three. First, it helps with the planning of upcoming services. Second, it helps with the completion of these services. And thirdly, it acts as an archive for servicing that has already been carried out, which can then, of course, be retrieved for reference whenever and wherever you want.
Fantastic. So it's a great help for crane operators. What are your next steps?
Some of our next steps involve the integration of other languages, as well as the implementation of other machinery.
Great. Thanks very much for these insights, Stefan.
Thank you.
Less weight for heavy lifting. That's the motto of the lightest 3-axle all-terrain crane on the market. And of course, it comes from Liebherr. With me now is product manager Florian Brunner. Hi, Florian.
Hi, Martin.
Florian, what can you tell us about the new LTM 1055-3.3?
Well, Martin, the new LTM 1055-3.3 is our lightweight in the three-axle class with a tremendous load capacity. When we were developing this crane, our goal was to create a lightweight crane that's easy to get on the road, is maneuverable on the road, but which can handle enormous loads once it's on the construction site. And I have to say, we did it. This crane allows a variety of driving states to be covered with various axle loads. We've even managed, by disassembling the counterweight, to achieve axle classes of less than 9 tons. This is unique for this crane class. The great advantage of this for our customers is that they can operate this crane comprehensively in many countries with a permanent permit. This saves them expensive individual road permits, road restrictions and support vehicles or passengers, all of which cost money. And this is definitely a game changer in the three-axle class.
So you're saying it increases flexibility, allowing permanent approval without any type of restrictions?
Exactly. The crane manages this by pulling its ballast behind it on a trailer. In this state, it arrives at the construction site with the entire ballast lying on the trailer, can lift it onto the crane later in a single lifting operation, and then it can get to work. That's ingenious. There's never been anything like this before.
So what's the load capacity like?
The load capacity is of course very important. What use is a lightweight crane if it can't lift anything? The crane's 40-meter telescopic boom means it performs brilliantly in the medium and large boom radius range. This is where its strengths lie. It does this primarily through its double-stage sliding struts at the rear. These give it a stable stand and tremendous lifting capacity with large boom radii. And with the supports, it's able to increase these load capacities even further thanks to the Vario Base Plus that's installed as standard. And this is an enormous advantage for our customers.
Now the crane of course also comes with a new Licon 3 crane control system and a stylish new design. Plus there are several technical features that increase cost effectiveness, comfort and most importantly safety, right?
Exactly. Safety is by far the crucial keyword. For us, it's everything when it comes to constructing cranes. This is why we decided to also install the new driver assistance systems on the crane's chassis, so that the crane's road safety is increased even further.
Fantastic. Thanks for these insights, Florian.
You're welcome, Martin.
In 2018, we unveiled our first compact crane, the LTC 1050-3.1, with remote drive radio remote control. The feedback was sensational. Offering the radio remote control for larger cranes, too, was therefore only a matter of time. So, in October, we upgraded the LTM 1100-5.3 and the LTM 1110-5.2. This isn't a bottleneck, but maybe the engineer will let me drive the crane over the bridge sometime. Via radio remote control, a crane can be operated entirely from the outside. It's always more effective if the crane driver has direct sight of the narrow point he has to maneuver past, instead of transmitting the view via cameras to the driver's cab. To operate the LTM 1100-5.3 and LTM 1110-5.2 by radio remote control, you just need the optional BTTE console, as shown here, which plugs into the standard BTT control panel. This console is compatible with all Licon 3 and Licon 2 cranes, both for the superstructure and the chassis control. Older cranes also don't have to do without remote drive. They can be easily retrofitted with a software update. The function is also available for future Licon 3 cranes, albeit up to 5 axle models. Here at Bauma, our focus is on our products and technology. However, in everyday operations, it's the skills of the crane driver that matter. This brings us to an exciting competition, the Game of Cranes, which brings together the best of the best in crane driving. Michaela Gogeißl, together with colleagues from the training center and several country organizations, developed the concept for this crane competition. Hello, Michaela.
Hello, Martin.
So, what's the Game of Cranes all about?
Our customers don't just have excellent cranes in their fleet, but they also have fantastic employees. And this is precisely who we wanted to find with our Game of Cranes. In this worldwide contest, we're searching for the best crane driver.
Let's take a little walk. So, how can you register for the competition?
Simply go to gameofcranes at liebherr.com and then register with your My Liebherr account.
And what disciplines are there?
For us, the focus is, of course, on safety. However, skills and technical understanding are also part of the challenge.
So what happens after registration?
After registering, crane drivers are prompted to upload their videos to social media. They can be uploaded to TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, or even Liebherr.com. The community's votes from around the world will determine who is the best crane driver.
And what happens after the votes are cast?
After the votes are cast, a professional panel of Liebherr judges will, of course, offer their opinions on the crane videos. Then it comes down to the local heats. These will be held in Brazil, the USA, Saudi Arabia, Spain, and Australia.
And when will the grand final be?
The grand final will be held in November this year in Ehingen. The five best in the world will be invited to Ehingen, where they'll attempt to take the title and hopefully make it to the Crane Drivers Hall of Fame.
So, crane drivers, get applying. You'll find the link below in the video description, and perhaps we'll see you in Ehingen. Thank you, Michaela.
You're welcome.
Well, that's all for now from Bauma 2025 in Munich. Thanks for watching and see you soon.